Hello everyone, welcome to the Security Center practical series. In today's session we will study the second part of the practical. I have done the first part, that is examining telnet and SSH in using Wireshark in the previous session. In this particular session we will study about the second part, that is investigating a malware exploit. So the software resources we're using is host OS is Windows 10, guest OS is Kali Linux, and the virtualization software is Oracle VirtualBox 7.0. So this is the second part we'll be doing, investigating a malware exploit. So what steps we'll be following? The first step is to get a clean copy of a malware. So I'll show you how to get the clean copy of a malware. Various websites are available. So you must download this malware from a trusted website. Otherwise, if we download this in our system, it may create havoc, it may actually damage our system. So second step is analyzing the malware using Kali Linux, and the step three is to investigate the type of malware. So malware is actually a malicious software, a software which is intentionally made for some destructive purpose. So let us do the first step to get the clean copy of the malware. Now how to get the clean copy of the malware? So we open up the browser and visit the website virusshare.com. So this is the virusshare.com. So here we need to log in first. Now login, we need a username and a password, but in case we are doing that for the first time, we need to create a username and password, but it is not giving us direct access for the username. So I click on this about information. And here we need to send a mail to this melissa97@virusshare.com. So send an email requesting to get to create the username ID. So they will send that. Okay, and the subject is access. So when we are writing the mail, we need to mention access in the subject and send a mail requesting to get the invitation link. So do this step. After doing this step, they will send the invitation to us, and then we can easily log in. So in my case, I have this login information with me. So I'll just log in. So here I have this login information, and I'll just enter the password. So I'll just log in. So here I am into my account detail. So we will download this. So here you can see the download option is here. Okay, I will just download this file from here. Okay, it will get downloaded. After downloading, it will ask for the password. So password is infected. Okay, the password is infected. Now after downloading, we can find this file in our downloads folder. So this is the file which I got from virusshare.com. I will copy this file and paste it in any of the folder, and then because I want to use Kali Linux, so I will copy this file from this particular system Windows, and I will paste it in on the desktop of my Kali system. Okay, so first I need to unzip this. So the password is infected. I will do that and then show the next steps. Now the next step is doing analysis using Kali Linux. So I just open this VirtualBox and start the Kali machine. So after downloading that malware, I have pasted it here. It is a zip file. So let us extract it. So I'll just extract it here. It is asking for the password. Password is infected. So here we have the file. Now this file is having a very complex name, a very big one. So let us convert this to a more simple one. So I'll just rename it to malware. So we rename this file. So we have this malware here. Now let us see what we can do with this file. What analysis we can do with the commands in Kali Linux. So I just open up a terminal. So the very first thing we do is we want to determine the type of the file. So before doing that, we must know the path of this. So I just click on malware, the right click, and in properties we see this is the path. Just copy this. Now I type the command file. So this command file, it will determine the type of the file. Okay, it does the analysis of the file. So let us paste this. So this, then of course the name of the file. So name of the file is malware. So this is what it gives. So it is a Windows based file is what we are given. So the system on which it works is 64, and it is an executable file. Now let us do some more analysis. We'll type the command SHA 256 and sum. I'll copy this extension, this file path. So what this SHA will do, it generates the SHA 256 cryptographic hash of the given file, and we can actually also verify this. So this is the hashed value. Okay. We can verify this. Then next is strings. And then of course the file path. Sorry. This is actually I had copied. So what we need is this one. So copy this and you paste it here. Now what this will do actually, it extracts the readable text strings from a binary or non-text file. So it searches for a sequence of printable ASCII or Unicode characters in the file. So let us see. So this is what we are getting. Okay. This is what we get when we type this string command. Okay. So it gives the long string what we have. This is it gives. Now what it does is it gives us the suspicious messages or file names or code comments, etc. We can get it. Then finally let us see the hex editor. And then paste this file extension, the file path, sorry. So this is what we are getting. Now what is the purpose is of this particular hex editor is that it gives us the, it opens the file in hexadecimal editor. It displays the raw byte contents of a file in hexadecimal and ASCII format. So we just come out. Now this things. Now to get more detailed analysis of this, we just open up the browser and we type we go to the website of VirusTotal. So we just VirusTotal. So it gives us, it is an online website which gives us the detail about the malware. We just need to paste that particular file here. So here you can see. So choose the file. So this is our file malware. So now it is checking and it will give us the detail. So this is the detail which we get from the malware. Okay. So these are the threats. we can even get some more details about this. That is the MD5 SHA. We can actually see here we given SHA 256. We also got the SHA in the previous case, so we can actually verify this, the SHA. Then when it was created, when the first submission, the last submission, this detail is given about that particular malware. Then we can also get the behavior. If you click here, this is the behavior. So what are the various types of attacks, what are the privilege escalation, then defense evasion, then how much credential access was actually captured. So these things we can actually do the analysis, a more detailed analysis, by visiting this VirusTotal. So that's all for this session. Thanks for watching.